Hey guys, Runesr4nerds here, and today I finished Torva. I just dropped the kit a few minutes ago, and I thought I'd just detail. I went over around 30 orbs for the kills, and I just screened each awakened boss attempt board, and then my main. I spent 250 to 300 orbs on there just to feel comfortable. Shout out Red Eye Jedi for tiles and other YouTube content creators, because those tiles helped a lot. And I recolored a few of them because I was picky, but anyway, I digress. So I'll probably revert my Torva a few times because it's not baggable anymore, and here's what I got in the bag right now, but it's pretty empty. Considering everything, because Masori is storable, and it's in my armor case. But anyway, if I revert the Torva, I just need to get orbs, one orb for the Awakened kill, and then I don't mind Runecrafting pet and Desert Treasure 2 pet hunting, so I guess reverting the Torva is not that big of a deal in the long run. I'm going to do it a couple times for some grinds, and for example 30 kill Kriara trip, having a Fang plus Torva in my MV is just gonna make it really challenging, but we'll see what I end up doing for that. Obviously it's doable eventually. So anyway, I greenlogged Duke. The axe is getting buffed, so I figured instead of dropping the axe piece, I'm gonna go finish the axe, because I don't have a scythe, and that's the only big item I really am missing still, other than GM, scythe, and maybe some Fasani's drops. I'm just gonna be pet hunting after this. Fang was just nerfed the other day, so the axe buff is coming soon. It's definitely noticeable at Duke, but at Vard it's not that big of a deal. I probably would have just waited for Scythe, or maybe done it with Voidwaker. So yeah, that's pretty much kind of all I wanted to cover. So I'm just going to go play the clips of each boss, and then I got some bloopers at the end of the video that were kind of funny. I think pretty much all of them are Leviathan kills. I deleted anything Duke that was long ago, and I just, yeah.